In this video, I'm going to show you a simple way to do vintage sunset designs in Affinity Designer using layer masks and layer effects. Let's go. Thanks for joining me on this video. My name is Juno with Detour Shirts, the channel all about helping you design and sell t-shirts online. If that's something you like to do, don't forget to hit that subscribe button. So in this video, I'm going to teach you about vintage sunsets. I probably should have done this video a long time ago. Vintage sunsets have been really popular in the last year or two. So this tutorial is going to be really good because I'm going to show you basic tools in Affinity Designer, mainly the rectangle tool and some of the different layer effects. You're going to want to stay to the end to see all the different vintage sunsets as well as another edition of trend credits. So let's get started. So here we are in Affinity Designer. I wanted to show you what happens when you start a new document. So first, you could choose letter here if you wanted to do that. You can see the dimensions are 8.5 by 11. If you wanted to do my presets, you could do that and save your own. Make a custom one, do pixels, and change this to 4,500 by 5,400. And that is your Merch by Amazon t-shirt size. Make sure it's pixels again. Let me move my face out of the way here. So now with my face out of the way, we can hit create. And there you have the size for Merch by Amazon. And you can check again, document setup, 4,500 by 5,400. If you want another one, you can just click this, insert artboard. So I'm gonna label this artboard t-shirt. In fact, merch t-shirt, MBA t-shirt. And then I'm gonna do another artboard. So let's click that again, insert artboard. And you can see this artboard here is the same exact size, but I can change the size. Let me show you how to do that. I'm just gonna click this transform here. And you can see it's 45 by 5400, 4500 by 5400. The hoodies are 4050 right there. So that's your hoodie size. So now you have both. I'm gonna say MBA hoodie. And of course you could do more for the pillows and the pop sockets and the phones and stuff, but that's how you do it if you want both here. So let me show you how to do the vintage sunset since that's what this video is about. I'm gonna come in here, zoom in. I'm gonna zoom in a little bit, and then I'm just gonna use this rectangle tool. Super simple. So right here, I'll draw a rectangle. No outline, just the color. I'm gonna start with red. Just pick a red here, okay? And then I'm gonna just hold down Option and Shift and drag. So Option, Shift, click on this and drag. That's just making a copy of it, right? Super simple. You can do that again and again, or you can just hit Command J and it will do it for you. So there is a super simple way to do vintage sunset. You would just change the colors in this case. So let me change this one to orange, yellow. You can see how that, like, right? You could change different colors here. This may not be the color scheme that you want, but I'm gonna show you, you can just change the color. So this is super easy way to do a vintage sunset. Let's see, you know, something like that. There's your basic sunset. Now we're gonna do it just a little bit different. We're gonna change the size of the rectangle. So let's say this one, we want this one bigger, and then each one of them after that is a little smaller. So this one's just a little bigger. This one's just a little smaller, right? This one's just a little smaller. And you can kind of eyeball it. There's no real right or wrong way to do this one. So if you want to make it bigger, smaller, and then bigger again, you can do that. But I'm just going to show you bigger, bigger, smaller. Like that, check that out. That's another way to do a vintage sunset. Now, most of you are thinking, when you think vintage sunset, you're thinking the circle version of vintage sunset. So let's do this. I'm gonna select all of these and I'm gonna make it a little smaller and group them. So now you can see I have this group this is my rainbow color group or vintage sunset. Let me just name it here, sunset, so you can see what's going on. So now I have the sunset. The next thing I wanna do is actually put it in a circle. So I have the circle tool here, and you can just make it, if you hold down shift, it will make it a perfect circle. You can see right there at the bottom, the width and the height are the same. And then just move it to the size that you want. Let me do this outline so you can see it better. So see right there, if that's what you want, if you want the whole thing to be in a circle, then you can do that. If you want half of it to be in a circle or just some of it, you can do that. So let's do the whole circle first, and then I'll come back and do just some of the circle. So here's the whole circle. You can see the circle is inside the group. So I'm gonna wanna remove this outline so it's not there, right? I'm gonna move the group that I have, this group, above the circle. You can see here in my layers palette, I moved the sunset above the ellipse or the circle. I can call this circle if you want, just so we have it. Okay, so what you wanna do now is just pull the sunset down into the circle and to the right. You see how I did that? Into the right. And now it's inside the circle. Now you have your vintage sunset in a circle. So let's go back and change the shape on this. I'm hitting Command Z to go back. And let's change that circle now to be a little bigger so it goes outside. So you can see we have that edge on the bottom now. We have that flat edge. Instead of it curving down, we have that flat edge. And you can make the circle as big as your sunset here. So let's do that. So now this circle is a different shape. So let's see what happens when we clip the sunset to that shape. Down and in, and there you go. So now you have this kind of sunset where the bottom is flat like that. Isn't that super simple? That's really simple, right? So the next thing you wanna do is just change colors, and that's real easy. If you wanna do different colors, you can just go in here, and these are still rectangles, and you can still change the colors on them. So let's say I want this to be a darker red, and I want this to be a darker color, right? You can still do that in here. Maybe you want it to be just a gradient of blue, so let's do that. So here's a vintage sunset of just a blue color, right? So you can see it's real easy to change the colors, and you can change the shapes too. So let's use a different shape. So if you just want to get rid of the shape and do it again, take this sunset outside of the shape now, and you can see the shape is still there, that ellipse is still there, and we can just delete it. And let's pick a different shape. Let's say I wanna do a shape that has kind of a round top but long on the sides. So that would just be a rectangle and a circle, right? So let's do that. So you got this kind of shape here where it's round on the top and long on the sides. So let me just put these two together, and then I'm gonna make it so it fits the shape. Do that, and then let's do this. So we have the shape, put the shape on the bottom again, right? And then make sure the shape doesn't have any color in it, and then put the sunset in the shape. Boom, there's a different vintage sunset, right? So the possibilities are endless. Not only can you change the color and the shape, but you can change the width of these vintage sunset rectangles, right? So if once you're in here and you want to make this rectangle bigger, you can. You want to make this rectangle smaller, you can. Now you may be thinking, what do I do if I want a shape in it? What if I want a silhouette in it now and change it? So let me go back to our colored one. I'm going to hit Command Z and go all the way back, let's see, to our nice vintage sunset that we had before with the circle. I want the colored one. Isn't this cool? Undo Z, undo, undo. Okay, let's say we're here and we want a silhouette in it. So I went ahead and grabbed this silhouette that I had. This is just a surfer silhouette. You can see it's just points here. So it is a vector as well. So I can put the silhouette on here and just make it to the right size. So let's say I want it, right there like that. And you can see that it's on here. Everything is grouped. This is grouped here. Just make sure this is on top. So once you have the silhouette on top of your sunset, you're gonna click on the silhouette and use this layer effect, and it is erase. So when you click erase like that, and you group both of these together now, let's group them together. So this is now the full sunset. If you had a black background, let's do a background here and make it black and put it in the back. You'll see that it knocked it out, right? So that's how you wanna do it. Super simple. I'm gonna get rid of that background. I'm gonna zoom out and let's say you want this. Now you can hold shift. Make sure that it's the right size for your shirt. Right there, center it. And maybe you want text underneath. I'm gonna do maybe surfer, make that bigger. I'm gonna use veneer, of course. So let's do, there's veneer. Surfer, I'm gonna make it white because this is gonna be on a black background. And I'm gonna stretch it out like that. And you can use whatever words you want, right? And you could use one of these colors in the sunset as well. So let me just use, I like this light color here. Surfer, I think that would look really cool. Okay, now you have this, you're gonna select on here and then I like to export. You can go to your menu and export, or you can hit Command Option Shift S and this will do export as well. That's a shortcut. And select your PNG file, make sure it's the right size right here. And then you wanna do selection only when you export and export. And then call it whatever you wanna call it. I'm gonna call mine Surfer and save. And that's how easy it is. Let me show you what happens when I saved it. So you can see my Surfer PNG file that I saved is knocked out. It's transparent and it's good to go. It's the right size, 5400 by 4500 for merch by Amazon. You can do the same thing for other sizes, as well as this hoodie. If you saved it to here, you could have done the same thing and exported it as a hoodie. So that's how easy it is to do a vintage sunset in Affinity Designer. Remember to use groups. Remember to use the shapes. We're masking here by dragging it underneath. And we also use the layer effects of erase to erase the silhouette from it. Super simple, guys. That is it for this video. Hopefully this video is really helpful for you. Hopefully now you can make your own vintage sunset super easy. There's lots of different techniques to do this. If you know a different technique or have used a different technique for vintage sunsets for Affinity Designer, let me know in the comments. And let me know if you have any other questions about vintage sunsets, about different, maybe different variations of vintage sunsets that you want to do. But this one is a super simple one. Of course, you can make yours different by changing the colors, the shapes, I mean, the size of the rectangles as well. So lots of variety you can do here. You don't have to copy anybody. You can make it your own. So thanks so much for watching this video. Hopefully it's really helpful for you. And your reward for staying all the way to the end is another edition of Trend Credits. Thanks for joining me for this trend credit. Here is your trend. Bye bye school, hello pool. You can see lots of low BSRs here. Well, those aren't very low. That's low, that's low. There's some low ones here as well. Let's check Merch Informer. It is getting an A, so you know it's good. If you don't have Merch Informer, I have a link to the description for Merch Informer. You can click on that and get Merch Informer and check your competition yourself, as well as get some graphics and some cool stuff on here. Let's go back to that trend. This trend is kind of saturated, but the reason why I wanted to share this trend is for two reasons. First, think about summer stuff. Summer things are gonna be really hot right now. People, this is definitely a summer t-shirt, right? School's over, going to the pool. So think of other summer designs when you're designing stuff. And if you're trying to create something original, this is a good way to do it. Don't copy this, but the rhyming part, see, school, pool, come up with your own phrase that rhymes and you could probably come up with your own original design. Think of things for summer, things that rhyme with summers, things that rhyme with dad, with barbecue, you know, even other things like guitars and cars, those rhyme. So different things like that. just brainstorm on doing the rhyming thing, and you could come up with your own trending phrase and be the first one to get there and sell a lot of t-shirts before people start figuring out that yours is really cool. So think about that when doing your own designs, your own original designs. That's one way to do it, is the rhyming phrases here. So that's why I wanted to share this with you. Not only is this a trend, but it's a good idea, a good way to do some other t-shirts, summer t-shirts, rhyming t-shirts, and things like that. So that is your trend for this video. So that is it for this video, guys. Thanks so much for watching. Hopefully this video is really helpful for you. Even if you knew how to do some vintage sunsets, hopefully there is something in this video that you learned how to do different in Affinity Designer. Maybe it's the colors, the shapes, the erase tool, or something like that. Let me know in the comments if there's other things that you want to learn how to do in Affinity Designer. I'd love to teach that to you. And if this video was really helpful for you, make sure to give it a thumbs up. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel. If you love doing these kinds of things, designing t-shirts, selling t-shirts online, this is the channel for you. If you want to see more videos like this on Affinity Designer tools, click these videos right here. And as always, guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one. Bye.